Hello and welcome. I'm Raghav and welcome to School of Basics. Today I'm going to take the topic how Appium works. And Appium, as you know, is a tool which is open source, is an open source platform and is used for automation on mobile platforms like Android, iOS and also on Windows desktop platform. Now, you might get this question a lot of times in interviews, or you might want to understand in general how Appium works, and I will go very basic step by step, and by the end of this video you will know exactly how Appium works and you will be confidently able to explain to anyone on this topic. So let's get started. And Appium works in a client server architecture or a client server design. So here we have a client. And we have a server. So we have a client and a server, and the client and server interact with each other using some common protocol and over some common network. So this is what a client and server design is. The client sends the request to the server and the server sends back the response. Now in Appium as well, we have the same concept or same design. So here we have a Appium client and we have a Appium server. So we have an Appium client that sends the request to Appium server and the Appium server sends back the response. Now, what is an Appium client and what is an Appium server exactly? So Appium client are actually the Appium client libraries that you can find on the Appium official documentation page as well. So these libraries are on different programming languages like Java, C Sharp, Python, JavaScript, Ruby, PHP, robot framework. So you can create your framework using any of these client libraries. So for example, if I want to create an automation framework in Appium for mobile testing and I want to create in Java, so I will download the Java client libraries and I will add them to my project or my framework and start creating the request. Similarly, if you want to create in C Sharp, you will download the C Sharp libraries. And I will also provide a link in the description of this video where you can see all these libraries and you can download it as well. So this is what an Appium client. We just download the Appium client libraries based on our preference of programming language, add them to our project, add them to our framework, and then we can create our request in that programming language. Now we send this to Appium server. What is an Appium server? So Appium server is a Node.js platform, and it is actually an HTTP server which is created over Node.js. And when you install Appium, you actually install the Appium server. It is not the Appium client that you install. When you install Appium, you install Appium server. Also, if you will go to the official website of Appium, which is appium.io, and you will scroll down, you will find the command to install Appium is npm install -g Appium. So this is a Node.js program, so we use npm to install Appium, and when we install Appium, we are actually installing an Appium server. So we need an Appium server, and then we create our framework using the client libraries, and then we send our request. Now we send our request to the server, and the server in turn sends the request to the mobile device where the action is performed. So here we have a mobile device. So the Appium server sends the request to the application on the mobile device where the action is performed. Now, this is a very basic architecture or design. However, there are three very important components in the design of Appium. The first one is JSON wire protocol. Now, what is a JSON wire protocol? It is a protocol that helps to convert the client request into a format that can be understood by the Appium server. So the client request that we send in any of these programming languages cannot be understood by the Appium server as it is. It needs to be converted. So JSON wire protocol is a protocol or a program that converts these requests into a HTTP RESTful request. So Appium server understands only HTTP RESTful request, and this is what converts it into the format that can be understood by the Appium server. So this is one important component. The other important component here is the mobile device native drivers. So we can do automation on Android, iOS or Windows app, Windows application, and they have, each of these platforms have their native automation drivers. For example, for Android we have UI Automator and Cylindroid. For iOS we have UI Automation and XCUI Test, and for Windows we have WinApp Driver. So in case you are doing automation on an Android device, if it is Android, the driver is UI Automator or Cylindroid. Cylindroid was used earlier in the earlier Android versions, and as of now we use UI Automator for Android. In case it is iOS, we use UI Automation or XCUI Test, and if it is a Windows platform, then we have Windows App Driver or WinApp Driver. So from Appium server, it can go to a Windows platform where we will use the Windows App Driver. In case of iOS, we will use UI Automation or XUI Test. And in case of Android, it uses UI Automator or Cylindroid. And these are the device specific or platform specific drivers or automation frameworks which are provided by these platforms. They are not part of Appium. These are provided by the these platforms. So Appium server interacts with these driver to perform action on that particular platform. So this was a second important component, the platform application drivers or the platform automation drivers. And then the third thing is desired capabilities. Now what is a desired capability? Desired capabilities are a set of key and value combination that we send along with our request that has information on like the name of the device, the platform, the version, UDID, etc. So it can have like device name, the platform name, version, UDID, etc. So for example, the platform can be Android and version can be 6.0 and so on. So when we send our request, we also send this desired capabilities along with our request, and this desired capabilities goes as a JSON object. So this goes as a JSON object to the Appium server, and then based on the desired capabilities we have given, it performs the actions on the platform accordingly. So this is a very basic, and this is the actual design and architecture of Appium, and this is how Appium works. And if you have any, if you have missed any step, you can watch this video again and you will have full confidence on how Appium works. And now you can go confidently and you can explain in any interviews or anywhere on how Appium works. I hope this session was very useful for you, and in case you want me to cover any other topics in School of Basics, you can write them down in the comment section below and I will cover them in the next episode. Thank you for watching.